Christ the King Sunday. Have you all heard of that before?
Yes.
It's a fairly new holiday, feast day. It was only come about since 1925. Pope Pius XI, he decided that Christians were becoming a bit secular in their beliefs and activity. They were starting to follow the empire more than they were following God and living into the reign of God's kingdom. I don't think the Pope was wrong, and I still don't think the Pope is wrong, and I'm really glad we have this Sunday to just take a breath, to stop, to pause, and to pray, especially in our particular secular society where we're continually being asked to rush and rush and rush at this time of the year. In the church, this is the ending of our liturgical year. This is the last Sunday of Pentecost, Christ the King. And next Sunday, we will begin Advent, where we will once again wait for the coming of Christ. It's a good idea to stop. Because we need to ask ourselves, who is this Christ? Who is our King? And what does that kingdom of Christ even look like? What is it supposed to look like? In this world, we hear of kings and kingdoms. They've actually been in the news just recently. There is a king who's been doing some stuff, crown prince technically, who his own fellow leaders feel he is guilty of. And yet, they're going to come in conference with him. And they've said verbally, I don't really want to be with him, but I need to be with him. Because of money, authority, power, because of the way our world is working, we need to be able to speak to each other. So that's how kingdoms in the world work. And kingdoms generally are nations with land and territories and boundaries. That's what we think of when we think of kings and kingdoms. However, what if God meant something completely different? The conversation today between Pilate and Jesus is so interesting. It's theological and it's political. For Pilate, it's political. Is Jesus claiming to be a king? Because if he's claiming to be a king, he's an enemy of the state. He has to be put to death. This cannot be allowed. So Pilate asks him, are you king of the Jews? And Jesus just refuses flat out to answer. He's not going to go there. And then Pilate asks him again. And this time, Jesus takes that political conversation and he changes it to the theological. And he says, you say that I am king. And for this I was born, and for this I came into this world to testify to the truth. Jesus doesn't claim to be the king, not the human king. He's stating, you say that I am king, in the way that we understand a king. However, in the same sentence, Jesus does claim the kingdom of God. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, for truth. So what if that means the kingdom always was, and the kingdom is now, and the kingdom will be? What if it means kingdoms aren't land and borders and human leaders with power and authority? What if the kingdom is us right now being active with faith and hope and love and forgiveness and justice and peace and truth and mercy? What if the kingdom isn't a place in a time? What if it's always and everywhere, and we are continually bringing it about by our actions, by our thoughts, by our words, by our deeds. The kingdom is action. It is living lives of hope and faith and with love. Jesus, as our King, was always teaching us and showing us that to be a true king in the true kingdom of God, it's not about your authority to tell people what to do. Rather, it's your power and authority to serve others. Jesus constantly was walking around and meeting people, especially people that no one else wanted to talk to, the people that others wanted to ignore, the people that others wanted to forget were there, the people that were bullied and ridiculed, oppressed, and left behind. And Jesus would say, come, come on, come eat with me, come talk to me, come hear me, come let me heal you if you want to be healed. And Jesus would teach, and he would equip, and he would lift up and encourage people. And then, what did he do? Well, you can't answer, you already know.
I didn't.
What would he do? After you were gathered together with Jesus, and you were fed by Jesus, and touched by Jesus, and heard Jesus, what do you do? Go. You go. Jesus sends us out. Jesus says, now that you know, now that you felt, now that you understand, you go. And you share. You share what you have. You share what you know. You share the love that you have witnessed and felt, and you give it to others. And when you do that, you are in God's kingdom. And those you encounter are in God's kingdom. So, being your deacon, I'm supposed to challenge you. So let me take a moment. And I just ask you this week to really take a moment and think about, who is my king? What are the kings and kingdoms I've set up in my life that I give my time, my energy, and my presence to? And if they're not of Christ, maybe think about setting them aside and refocusing and recentering on the one who gives life, the one who redeems, and the one who sets us free to be who we are meant to be. Give Christ that power and authority over your life again, and ask him to teach you and lead you and guide you and equip you to be the amazing and wonderful human being that he created you to be. And in the process, please share that. Please share that with everyone that you encounter, that you are loved and you are known and you are amazing, and so are you.